I will introduce the speaker of this session, session speaker of this session, Dr. Neelima Satyam from IIT Indore. Of course, he is a well-known expert in the area of geotechnical engineering, particularly geotechnical earthquake engineering. And I know her personally also more than 15 years. We have attended several conferences nationally, internationally, particularly in conference in San Diego in USA with the Professor P.G. Sitaram, and we are all attended. And later on also in Italy, Termonia, also we attended. Both are related to earthquake geotechnical engineering. And of course, we have more interaction with the PhD students, with the PhD students. So everyone know her by data, but anyway, for young students, I would like to also go through his bio data. So currently, he is an associate professor and head of the discipline of engineering at IIT Indore. She obtained PhD as well as M.Tech from IIT Delhi and a bachelor degree from SV University Tirupati. And also after that, she worked for a long period at Earthquake Engineering Research Center, IIIT Hyderabad. And of course, he visited several international universities, including University of Stuttgart and University of Tokyo, actually. And his main area of research is earthquake engineering, microzonation, and site response studies. Of course, he has received several, I know that she was a lot of research projects funded by several agencies, including DST, ISRO, MOAS, actually. And he also a member of PMC committees, PAC committee of SARC, DST, and also received several awards, BR Nurse Young Scientist Research Award, AICT Career Award, Young Woman Engineer Award, and also she is actively earlier associated with the IJS Hyderabad chapter. Now currently he is actively participating in IJS Indore chapter. So with this introduction, I would like to request Dr. Neelima Satyam to give a talk on seismic site characterization as well as the related to the particularly pile supported structures. Thank you.
So thank you so much. So good afternoon, everyone. My topic is on seismic site characterization and dynamic analysis of a pile supported wharf system. So this work has been done by my student, PhD student, who will be submitting her thesis at IIT Hyderabad. So there are two parts of this particular lecture. So first one is like a detailed dynamic site characterization and ground response analysis, which we have carried out for the Vizag port city. And then the second part is like soil structure interaction, basically the complete wharf system considering the liquefaction also. So as we know that dynamic soil structure interaction is considered to be the primary step in any microzonation process or studies. And especially for the city like Vizag, this is developing very, very exponentially in terms of all kinds of infrastructure projects, including high-rise buildings are coming up and a lot of oil and gas related port structures. So it is one of the very critical or very important to do such kind of studies. And this is the overview of my presentation. And I'll just start with a brief introduction, and then the first part will be taken care of by the first three items, dynamic site characterization, PSH analysis, and the site effects. And the second part is basically the pushover analysis and nonlinear dynamic analysis of the wharf system with the final conclusions. So as we know that wharf structures are constructed parallel to the shore, especially for mooring the ships. And any damage to such structures may lead to inefficiency of the complete port operations. So, but not much importance has been given for such kind of structures, especially for to carry out the site-specific dynamic analysis. So that's why we have started this particular problem, I think, 3-4 years back. So seismic performance of the pile-supported wharf. So So which is not addressed well even in the codal provisions of the several countries. So coming back to the study area, as I said, my first part is most focused on the Vizag urban part of the Vizag city. Vizag is a very typical geological setup. It has a lot of outcrops, and at the same time, the soils are also varying from the very soft marine clays to a lot of weathered strata. And this is a city is located in the peninsula shield. As we know that it was a belief among seismologists in the past that peninsula shield is seismic, but however, several earthquakes, including the Bhuj, Koyna, and Bhadrachalam earthquake, and many more. Even there was an earthquake in 1970, which is called Broch earthquake, and Hyderabad also. So these have altered the belief and widely accepted that the seismic activity is still on moderate to mild scale. So there is a focus to lot of people have done lot of very site specific studies even in the peninsula region, including the Jabalpur, Chennai, Bangalore, and many more cities. So we started with Vizag and Vijayawada. So the coast of Bay of Bengal, because this is a port city and also having a coastal part of the Bay of Bengal, and this coast of Bay of Bengal is considered to be a weaker zone with the new tectonic activities establishing since in the recent past. As I said, the city is growing exponentially in the last 10 years, and this city is one of the very important and largest port city in the country, and is also highly densely populated. So my presentation will just give you a framework to assess both the detailed seismic hazard, structural performance, and also for the economical issues, because this is an important critical port structure which we have considered as a whole. So if you look at as I said, we have considered the urban part of the Visakhapatnam or Vizag city, and the topography is very undulated with hills characterized by the eastern ghats, and there are major mineral groups that are available, or condolites, which are followed by charcoalites, quartzites, and pegmatites. And since our bedrock is highly undulating, we could collect a lot of pore log data. So almost 258 pore log data we could collect. And the soils are predominantly, as I said, it is widely ranging, from weathered rock to soft marine clays. So typical some bore log data that whatever we collected, but basically what we have done here is we started with the probabilistic seismic hazard assessment, which we did it in four different steps as per the standard procedures, identification of the sources. When we look at the sources, actually there are 107 events from the period 1828 to 2018 were being considered for the analysis, and then we have done that data completion analysis, and then regional recurrence parameters have been established, calculated, and we compared it with the already published literature, and then ground motion prediction hazard curves were done. So in the data completion test, what we have done here in this particular one is because the seismic history, seismotectonics of the region, earthquake frequencies, and from the potential sources, maximum magnitude, attenuation of the strong motions, so all has to be considered in the seismic hazard analysis. So and here, as we said, bedrock is also been considered because we would like to carry out the ground response analysis after this PSHA. So with the data completion, because this is one of the very crucial step, so we used the standard approach of Kichku approach, as the seismic data is found to be incomplete due to the variety of seismic records that we had. And when we did this analysis for finding out A and B parameters, we got almost 2.4 as A and 0.691 for B, which has been very much the values whatever we got has been found good match with the literature by Professor Sitaram and Anbalgan and Jaiswal, and there were four more papers who have been worked on the entire region. So our values were been in good match with the published literature. Then we have considered five sources basically, and then we used the attenuation relationship developed by Raghukant and Iyengar for the peninsular shield, and so that we can carry out the hazard curves. So the hazard curves has been generated for all these five sources at bedrock level, and then what we found is the hazard curves with accident probability of 0.1 in 50 years for a return period of 475 years has been observed, and then attenuation relationship, as I said, this is the equation which we adopted or used from the literature, and the hazard maps for the study area have been developed for the structural time period of 0.1 and 0.2 seconds for a probability of 10%. So the results of the PSHA have been compared, and it was observed to be good match with the even the published by the NDMA report in 2011. And the green bands in this particular figure in the hazard maps are located near the faults that are present beneath, and these areas are showing higher PGA when compared to the other locations. Then after that, we moved to the detailed ground response analysis. Of course, we followed the standard approach. We took the site-specific soil data, and then we used deep soil, which is actually equivalent linear ground response analysis approach. Total 248 boreholes have been used. And in the starting, we used the boost ground motion. But what we have done here is we have considered the maximum horizontal acceleration of 0.106. But with a bracketed duration of 19.98 seconds. So these were the peak ground acceleration maps which we could generate at surface and the bedrock. So based on this results, what it suggests is the city is prone to higher accelerations than the acceleration specified in IS 1893:2016. PGA values at the surface were ranging from 0.08 to 0.14 g. Whereas at the bedrock, whereas at the surface, it's ranging from 0.08 to 0.14 for the surface, 0.08 to 0.11 for the bedrock. Then we could generate the amplification map for the city, and the locations that are present in the extreme southern part has higher response due to the presence of these tidal flats, especially for the marine clay formations. And the northeastern and the northern part of the city has shown lesser PGA due to the presence of these outcrops. Then the second one, then what we have done is for estimation of the local site effects, we use the standard microtremor method, which has been proposed by Nakamura, which is widely used and of course very well validated throughout the world. And this method is very quick also, where we can install, we can put the system on the ground and get the recordings for 3 hours, and then we can do the analysis. So the equipment has a velocity sensor and of course with a recording unit. So these were the locations where we have carried out the microtremor test in the Vizag city. And students, she carried out the early hours of the day so that we'll avoid some of the ambient noise. And then we carried out the three hours data has been collected, and then processed the data to get the predominant frequency and H-by-wave amplitude. So based upon the shape of the curve and the values, so and also the site-specific soil characteristics at that location, so we classified that into three different types: type 1, type 2, and type 3. So as you say that type 1, which is having the higher frequency of greater than 4, where the soils were being characterized as gravelly sand and with pebbles and soft disintegrated rock also, where SPT values were being higher than 4, and even the shear wave velocities are being coming more than 310. And in the type 3, which is the lowest frequency, which is almost less than 2 Hz, so they were very typical marine clay formations have been formed with silty clays also, and very soft with the N values less than 15, and of course the VS also was almost less than 200. So the microtremor curves for all the three types of classification that we have done here. Then this is the map showing the peak frequency and amplitude for the city of Vizag. So from the analysis of this particular local site effects, the peak frequency and amplitude have been estimated, but the frequency values were ranging from 0.3 to almost 10 Hz. And what we observed, as I said, the T1 sites, which have been classified as competent soil, I can say, with the rock and gravelly soils, weathered rock formations. So it is much safer, especially for the site effects, etc. Whereas in the soft marine clays with higher amplitudes have been observed in the type 3. Then predominant frequencies of 35 locations have been fitted linearly with the bedrock depth, because for somehow we could manage to get at least 35 locations among the, we got the data till the bedrock. So marginal error up to 15% was being observed, so which was considered to be fine. And vulnerability index was also observed higher at some of the locations, especially at Pendurthi and PM Palam and other some of the parts of the northern parts of the city, which indicating higher damage potential. And the proposed empirical relation between the depth and the sediment to the predominant frequency found to be reliable with a very marginal error. As I said, it was around 15%. And then what we have carried out here is like we would like to do the liquefaction analysis considering the WAF system. So we use the PANLC guidelines for the WAF design. So what it has, like, you know, method A is a simplified analysis wherein WAF tends to behave like a single degree of freedom structure under transverse response. Method B is a multi-mode spectral analysis in which several piles in a line are lumped as a standalone element. So in our thing, what we have done is like we have tried to see do with method C, which is a nonlinear static Kushore analysis, and method D is a time history analysis. So that what we have considered in our studies, method C and D have been adopted. So this is what we have done for the methodology part. So if the data is liquefiable, then redesign the complete system again as the liquefaction, and then selection of the acceptable damage level and the level of ground motion, then carrying out a nonlinear static pushover analysis for finding out the site-specific response vector. So from the Vizag Port Trust, we could get some of the details of the WAF structure. So and of course, all the details, especially for the berth and length of the vessel, width of the vessel, everything we could get it. So if you see here in this particular thing, there is a touch pile wall, which is almost 1250 mm diameter, cast in situ board pile. And then it's paced with a 1290 centimeter mm center to center. And then there is a grid B, grid C, grid D, E, F, and G piles were there. So there are three rows of 1250 mm diameter piles, and then another three rows followed, which are around 1400 mm diameter piles. So these are these piles to support the deck structure, and also they can accommodate 10 meter and 22 meter gauge quarry cranes also. So what we have done is like we have considered as soil spring stiffness are given at each 1 meter interval to the pipe to accommodate the soil structure interaction effect. And spring stiffness are calculated using the Borlaug data that whatever we got it from this particular site. So we did the SAP analysis. So this is the details of the numerical model of the WAF system. And then moment curvature relation is one of the most important input parameter to carry out nonlinear analysis of a framework structure. So we could do that, and nonlinear analysis requires evaluation of these nonlinear hinge properties at every section in the particular structure, and then computed by the strength and deformation capacities. So what we have done in this present study was like nonlinear hinge properties of the framed elements have been evaluated using the section in SAP 2000, and then that has been assigned to the numerical model. So from the analysis, what we could find out that the grid C piles have been more critical because the hinge formed first in those pile group. Then we compute the horizontal component of the spectral acceleration part. So here what we have done is site-specific response spectra has been calculated based on AC7, that code, and as per the section 11.4. And then the construction of the spectrum requires site-specific mapped spectral acceleration, and for short period of 0.2 seconds and a long period of almost 1 second. With a return period of 2475 years has been done considering 5% damping on rock level. So which was around 0.176 G and 0.048 G respectively. So rest of the procedure we followed the as per the AC7 code. Next, so then later what we have done is like we also considered 5 different earthquakes. Actually, the details of the earthquakes are not here, but it was in the paper. So considering that Taiwan earthquake, Loma Prieta, and 1999 Japan earthquake, and another earthquake in China. So we have considered 5 different earthquakes, and the response matrix obtained from the time history analysis have been further used for facility curve development. So then coming to the conclusions. So in the first part, when we carried out the probabilistic seismic hazard assessment, the A and B values what we obtained, so they define the regional recurrence for this particular city study area, and which is good match with the available literature, and the hazard curves and the maps, whatever we got it from the PSH analysis, will be very useful, especially when someone is designing considering the site effects. Then it will be really good because the city is coming up with a lot of infrastructure projects. And the study is eventual in generating the preliminary micro solution maps, where we could develop to considering the complete geological, geotechnical, and seismic data, which will be useful even for the state disaster management authorities for managing or mitigation of the risk associated. The predominant frequency values will be very useful, especially for the initial planning of the high-rise structures that are coming up in the city. And coming to this WAF system, the fundamental time period of this complete structure, as per according to our code, comes out to be 0.913 seconds. Whereas the dynamic mode shape analysis, what we could get it, so there is a variation of almost it coming out to be 0.063 seconds. So there's a great difference among these two values, so which can lead to the overestimation of the seismic forces. And the dynamic model time period and the pile supported WAF system that we considered in this particular analysis is one of the very crucial, not only for this Vizag city and also maybe for other port structures also. So damage to these structures also has a huge impact on the economic loss and port activities. So with this, I'll thank you so much.